Now, for the manual HDR, we're just going to start with one image. A lot of people say, okay, well, I'm going to open all seven of these and I'll stack them all up. No, just start with one image, see what the problem is. So let's say for the normal here, this is what your light meter said, hey, this is going to be a pretty good exposure for this scene. You're like, okay, I'll believe you. So you take the photograph and let's start with that one there. And look around the image and say, well, what does this thing need? Maybe it's a little bit too dark around the edges here. You know, the window's at the far end of the hallway and it gets darker as you come inward. So maybe I want to lighten up around the inside here. Well, if I wanted to lighten it up, which exposure would I go to? I'd go to the pluses, wouldn't I? So I go to plus one. Don't do too large of a jump either. If you try to go from like normal to like plus three, I really want to brighten this up, you'll notice it's a really strong difference between. So just one stop at a time. And some people will actually go in like half stop increments, but I'm going to call it my plus one image. Yeah, a little too dark around the outside. Aha. There's my normal. There's my plus one. You can see it's a little bit lighter around there. So how can I get this plus one onto the normal version? The easiest thing. I could copy and paste it. That would use up a little bit of RAM, but I could simply duplicate the layer. If I right-click on the name, duplicate layer, and I will call it plus one. If you want to save some time, you can use the plus symbol. I actually typed out the word plus. And for the destination, where's it going to go? I'm going to send it to my normal exposure, and I'll hit OK. Don't need this document anymore. I can close it down, got what I needed from it. And if I look on my normal exposure, oh look, there's the plus one sitting on top. There's the normal down below, and I'll actually rename that normal. That's my normal exposure. And there's the plus one, boink, on top. Now, for the most part, I want the normal to be visible. I only want to bring that plus one in a few areas, just kind of around the top up here. So I'm going to give it a layer mask. And I could, with a paintbrush, start painting with black to hide, but there'd be a whole lot of stuff that I need to fill in there. So maybe I will fill this layer mask with black. I'll do the old Command-I to invert it. Or does anybody know how to call up a hide all layer mask right off the bat?
Option.
Hold the Option key. If you Option click on the new layer mask icon, boink, gives you a hide all layer mask. Now I can grab a paintbrush. And for something like this, it's almost like I want to take like a big spotlight and kind of shine it into those areas over there. So I'm going to take a big brush. Should I do a hard-edged brush? Probably a soft-edged brush. That's more like an actual spotlight. But if I take the hardness all the way down, watch this. It's like just shining a little spotlight into those darker areas, and it just kind of lights them up a little bit. Now, things like, see this guy standing at the top of the stairs here. If I'm using a soft edge brush, look at how soft that transition is. We have areas in here where it's kind of partly hidden. So we're seeing some of the normal exposure and some of the plus one. And if I get to something like this, where there's like a person in there, you can get those weird ghostly, you know, things happening. So this is where you get to decide who lives and who dies. Do you completely hide the guy or do you completely reveal him? I'm going to get rid of him. Sorry, dude. I'll work away around the outside there, like that little spotlight, just lighting things up. Watch out for stuff like this. I've got the same lady following herself up the stairs. So same deal. You got to decide who lives and who goes. All right. And if you decide, yeah, it's still a little bit too dark down there, go on to another exposure, maybe the plus two. I'll send that one over, and I will name it plus two. Send it to the normal. Hide it with a layer mask. Option click. Boink, away it goes. And I can bring it back just in that area down there. Maybe a full-on plus three. We'll give you a few minutes to play around with the adding light, and then we'll take a look at darkening things down. All right? So start with your normal exposure. Just open them one at a time. You don't want to end up with this big stack of confusing stuff. And depending on what you're trying to do, sometimes a large brush is appropriate, sometimes a small brush. Like remember I used a really large brush to make it look like I was kind of just shining a big soft spotlight into there. Sometimes I'll see people trying to do stuff like this with a harder edge brush. And look at what we're getting happen along there. Same sort of deal. You're getting that kind of a dark mark along the edge, almost like that auto HDR look. So play around with the size of the brush. You can even play around with the opacity of the brush if you like. Okay, so guys, let's take a look at darkening down some of these windows here. Like in the middle here, we got, oh, look at how bright these windows are. Well, let me pull in a minus one here. And let's say I want to bring back, say, this window here. I can paint in that minus one. Now here's a bit of a conundrum. If I'm using a soft brush like this, remember using a nice big soft brush and I start painting this back in. There we go, bringing in that minus one. When I get to the edge here, how close do I go to the edge of the wall? If I go too close, we get that kind of scorch mark down the side there. If I don't go close enough, I don't want to get that scorch mark, we end up with a bright spot down here. Well, that's where the radius is the size of the brush. And this brush, the hardness of its edge is quite a bit softer. Or actually, I've already outlined this one. Right up here. And the radius of this brush is quite a bit softer than the transition from this side of the wall to this side. Like, we talked about the idea of there being no hard edges in Photoshop. You'll never see something where, you know, the foreground starts at this pixel and the background ends at this pixel. There's always this kind of transition edge in here. And right now, this brush is a much softer edge than the window frame. But what if I took a smaller brush? What if I... and did something maybe around... there we go. And with a shift click, boink, I could jump around the outside of it. Now, I've already kind of done it on this window down here, and there I've already outlined this window. Imagine you'd already gone all the way around the window, and this whole area here needs to be filled in with black. And you'll notice I went around this guy walking with the bottle. The reason I did that was if you get rid of him, you end up with legs walking down the hall with no person attached to it, which I find disturbing. So remember back in first semester, there was that girl that had the red flower and we turned it to blue, so we went all the way around the outside of the flower, and then we filled in this whole area. How did we do that? Anybody remember? This is a mask, so we had to select part of this mask here, and the magic wand tool is pretty good for selecting large areas. If you're trying to make a selection to, like, you know, extract something, it's probably not going to make a really good edge, but for this, I mean, it's just a big flat area of black to select, so I could... default tolerance is around 32. Click in there, boink, it selects that inner part, and I could then fill it with white, except, wait, what's this fringe all the way around here? Remember she had that fringe? How do we get around that fringe? What do we do to avoid that fringe? We expand that selection. So we took our selection, we modified it in some way by expanding it, and I'm going to take a guess at 3 pixels. 4 would have been better. Command Z, undo it. There's a little bit of trial and error. If it goes too far, undo it, do a smaller amount. If it doesn't go far enough, I usually undo it and then type in a larger value. You could just simply, it needed 2 more pixels, add 2 more pixels. However you do it, once it jumps outwards and encompasses that fringe, you can then choose Edit, Fill. For contents, choose white, hit OK. Command D, get rid of the marching ants. If anything got missed, just go in and clean those up. Always take a look around your mask after you're done. Make sure everything is nice and clean. And there's that darker window added in. Although I did end up with the same guy walking down with no legs. More of the lesson of don't have people in there. But there you can see that's a nice clean edge. So sometimes you got to do hard masking. Sometimes you want the soft masking. It's just a matter of playing around and seeing what it is that you want to keep in any given image.